I want to take a few minutes here to talk about this Navionics app for your smart device and apply it to ice fishing. We've all used these Navionics apps now. I think most people are familiar with them. If you're not, not a problem. I'm going to talk to you about how these things work and help you understand the power of this app, especially for an ice angler. Now, it's starting to get cold out now. Some ice anglers are on the ice already in northern parts of the region. We're not quite seeing ice here in central Minnesota, but we are very close. Ice is forming, just not quite ready to be walked on. But we are days away, if not weeks away, to hitting the ice. So let's talk about how this app can help you become a better ice angler. For one, you can see here it's a mobile GPS in your hand. So as I move around, driving my truck, walk around, that red arrow icon in the middle of the screen is my current position. Now, I happen to be sitting in my garage, so I'm not on a lake. So as you walk around on a lake, driving a lake, it's going to drive around the contours. I think we all understand that concept. So that center red arrow is my current position. That moves when I move. Super cool, especially if you're going to use this as a GPS in your truck to follow lake contours. It's really nice to know exactly where you are to take away some of the guesswork for a day of ice fishing. Now I want to talk about some of the features on this app that you probably are not aware of and how they apply to ice fishing. So for starters, I'm big on doing homework the day before a day on the ice. I can scroll around, zoom out, go to a lake I think about fishing. Let's go in here and let's say I'm going to fish Buffalo Lake. There we go. I zoom in. I can see all the contours. Super cool. I can plan the spots I want to fish. I can add waypoints for places I want to check out so I can be more efficient. If I'm wasting time in the ice, guess what? You're not catching fish. Time is valuable. So I can go over here the day before and say, you know what? I'm going to check this offshore point, underwater point right here. So boom, I can hit the question mark icon and it brings up a menu. I can now add a waypoint on this spot without even being there. You hit that marker button. Now you're going to see selected location and your GPS location. Make sure it's on selected location, because if it's on your GPS location, guess what? I just added a waypoint where I am in my garage. I don't care about that. So it's already on selected location. I can now scroll down. I can even choose the icon. I can have the generic pin. There's a dot, fish A, B, C, D, you name it. So I'm on fish B icon. Now if I hit save, you can see right there, it saved that icon right there where I want to check. So now I can scout out some of these spots the next day. I kind of have a game plan. You're taking away the guesswork and you're being more efficient. And I can easily go back here, hover over it, marker one, question mark icon. It goes back to this screen. I hit that marker one button down there and I can delete it. I don't need that on here. Boom, it's gone. So you can plan your day of fishing. It's so important to do your homework and to take away some of that guesswork. Practice efficiency, be productive, you will catch more fish. So let's go back over here to where the cursor is and talk about some things that we can do here to be more efficient with our exact positioning. So for one, bottom left-hand part of the screen, you see that arrow icon in that blue circle. If I hit that once, it's always gonna take me back to my position. So let's say I'm looking over here, I'm looking for a spot and I'm on the ice, whatever. Oh, this spot looks good. I can always go quickly back to where I am in relation to that spot by pushing that button. You hit that button again. Now you can see this is going to face the exact direction I'm facing. I'm literally turning my body in the garage. That's all I'm doing. And you can see that orientation change. Now this is super nice if you're walking out because it's super responsive. I can follow this exact road, this exact spot, this exact access. And it's super nice if you're following a contour line. So this is a feature I think a lot of anglers don't know exists. And it automatically faces the orientation I'm going. So now if I'm walking, let's say to a landmark or following a piece of structure or an inside turn in a weed bed, I can walk from hole to hole. So if I now see I caught a fish in one spot and I catch a fish, let's say 50 yards away, as I'm walking to that hole, I can see maybe how these fish are moving, how they're migrating from spot to spot. And I can follow that exact direction. Really cool feature. Now, if I hit that button again in the bottom left corner, I can now go straight to a position and it draws you a straight line. I can go right to a position. You can see the direction I'm walking. So if I'm walking towards, let's say, an access at night, I can point this red line right at that access and I can walk right towards it. you know, a nice feature as well. Hit that button again. Boom, it takes you back to the original orientation where I can just move around on your more generic screen. So a really cool set of options by hitting that button on the bottom left. There you go. You got it normal. Hit it again, the orientation mode. I can go to a spot and back to normal. Now, right above that button is two boxes. Looks like two overlapping square boxes. I hit that. One button takes up, pulls up map options. Now I can adjust my layers, my overlays. I can my orientation. I can get into different modes. There's all kinds of stuff you can get into. And without getting too far into the weeds, I'll show you some of the basic stuffs I think that really apply to an ice angler. You're going to have your satellite there. You can see in the middle of that screen, overlays, satellite. Boom. Now I can see all kinds of stuff. If I am trying to drive to an access in my truck, it will show me street names. I can follow street names and my position will drive around as I move. It'll show me where an access is. It'll show me maybe a parking lot where I need to park at. There's so many places to consider for ways to get on the ice in the wintertime than there is in the summertime. So this may help you do some research on places to access the lake, where to park, how to get on and off. Your buddy might tell you, hey, there's a little park right here that you can park at, and he can send you a pin and you can drive right to it. So you can do the satellite stuff, which is a cool feature, because I'll use this in my truck when I'm driving to and from the lake. I can follow the roads, whatever it might be, and drive right onto the ice with my pickup truck and in the early ice, maybe an ATV. Again, you can use this as more than just a fish catching tool, but an actual GPS in the palm of your hand. And easily to take that off, I'm going to go back to the icon with the two squares, hit that again, it pulls it up, and I can just hit no overlay, and I'm back to normal mode where I can zoom in with lake contours and all that fun stuff. So I'll oftentimes use that quick button on the left, map options, to do all kinds of stuff, but satellite's a cool feature, especially for ice anglers, and it's just a quick option instead of drilling down into the menus. One button, boom, map options right on your screen. Then above that is a pin icon. Now what that's going to do is going to quickly add a waypoint exactly where you are. So obviously I'm in my garage. If I was on the lake, that red cursor will be on the lake at that contour, and I want to add a waypoint. Let's say I find some weeds, I find a rock pile, I catch some fish. I just hit that one button, boom, it adds a waypoint on my GPS. It's there, super easy. And again, if I want to delete it, I hover over it, it says marker one, hit that question mark icon, marker one, delete it. I don't care about a waypoint at my house. I can take that off and it's gone. So quick button waypoint if you're catching fish, marking a contour, marking something specific, want to give your buddy a position on where you're at in the lake. Like, here's my position. I can hit that button, boom, and I can tell my buddy just like this, marker one. There's my GPS location. I can hit that share button right there as well. I can share that with somebody. Super easy to do. I can share that with somebody, give them my position, and they can go, no problem, I see where you're at. Hey, now I know your hotspot, whatever. But you can share that position. I'm going to go back here and delete that again. I don't want that on here. It's gone. So super easy. A bunch of features you may not have thought of. Another cool feature with this app is on the bottom right-hand corner, you can see there's a marker down there that allows you to judge your distance from spot A to spot B. So if I hit that button in the far bottom right corner, there, now my distance. I can adjust these pins. So let's say I want to know how far it is to right here, because that's where my buddy is. I can say, hey, bud, you're 0.7 miles away from me. So you have a pretty good idea of how far a piece of structure is from you, maybe how far, how long a reef is, you know, whatever it might be. You can adjust this to tell you exactly how far. So if I wanted to go, let's say over here to Round Lake, I am 1.4 miles away. So that's a cool feature on the ice, because you may be able to tell yourself how far you've worked a weed line, how far a school is from today to yesterday. So there's so many things you can do than just turning this on and having it be a GPS. You can actually really use this to figure out information, to remember things, to make educated guesses, to do all kinds of stuff. So don't just use this for a GPS. Use the features inside this to be a better angler. I hit that button and that's gone. So I'm big on using this Navionics app. I use it all the time. I rely on it quite a bit. I'm playing with it with my kids, with my buddies. If I'm sitting at a dinner or lunch with a friend planning, I'll scroll down and say, oh yeah, you know, going to go to Lake Minnetonka. Here's some spots I caught some fish on. But not only that, but when you're on the ice, you can save waypoints. You can adjust your overlay. You can figure out how far you are. You can make spot-specific coordinates, waypoints for where you caught crappies today, where you caught them tomorrow, where you caught them the next day, and plan some of these movements. And then I can go back in and adjust the distance from those movements. So there's so much you can do with this Navionics app. I encourage you to download it if you don't have it already. And if you have it already, hopefully this sheds some light on some of the features you can use on this Navionics app. And I just touched the tip of the iceberg. Drill down into this map options button on the bottom left. Go in there, play with some more of this stuff. You'll be amazed at what this app can truly do that most of us do not realize. It's not just an app to show you the contours. It's so much more than that. And I think it has a ton of value for an ice angler. So the Navionics app for ice fishing is definitely something I rely on every single day. And that's something you should consider as well. So go out there, catch some fish, have some fun, and be safe on the ice.